All right, 9:47 is the time. The McNeil government and the Nova Scotia Teachers Union met yesterday to discuss union concerns about the government's plan to implement the recommendations from the Glaze report. And the two sides say they will meet again. The NSTU, of course, is calling on the province to hold off making any such moves and is threatening a job action, including a possible wildcat strike. Joining me on the phone this morning with some thoughts on this and another issue is the leader of Nova Scotia's Democratic Party, Mr. Gary Burrill. Gary, good morning to you.
Good morning to you.
How are you doing this morning, sir?
Great, thanks. Minus a little cold.
Yeah, it's a little chilly out there, but it is winter. It is February. Gary, let's talk about the teachers first. What's your advice to the education minister, the premier? What would you tell them, or what would you do if you were the premier today?
Oh, gosh. I think that the premier and the education minister have just made a terrible mistake by so very, very quickly adopting all of these recommendations and then rushing headlong into their implementation. They're going to create chaos and havoc throughout the school system at just the time when what we need is systematic, orderly investment in supports in the classroom. I think what they need to do is put the foot on the brake. They just we haven't been doing this in the right direction. We've got to pause. We've got to think plainly. Teachers know something about this. If teachers are so incensed to vote 80-some percent for a strike to oppose it, maybe we ought to rethink where we are. I think they should be thinking where they are. I think they should be calling in their own, putting both feet on the brakes.
But would you support an illegal wildcat strike to back their demands?
No, that's not for me to say. That's for the union to say. But I would say that it is an indication of how deeply, deeply concerned the teachers of the province are with these recommendations about obliterating all school boards and creating one super central bureaucratic authority to look after education across all of Nova Scotia. They're so concerned about that that in a situation where it is illegal, they have given their executive a strike mandate to go ahead. So it's a sign of very seriously, the people who know the most about this subject in Nova Scotia, the province's teachers, that take this matter.
Do you get the sense that the McNeil government has opened the door somewhat to maybe backing off, implementing some or all of those recommendations? The fact that they're now talking with the union, they had a conversation yesterday. Apparently, they'll meet again, maybe as early as today. Do you see that as perhaps the government softening its stand, or is it just kind of doing this just for the sake of doing it, to perhaps to quiet the union down a bit?
We'll have to see about that. I can't say anything about their motivation. I can only say that what they ought to do is recognize that a significant majority of people who are specialists in these areas in Nova Scotia, the teachers, are very deeply incensed and concerned about these recommendations. And therefore, they should put their foot on the brake, pause the whole matter, and give it a great deal more consideration. That would be the prudent and wise thing for them to do.
9:51 is the time. NDP leader Gary Burrill on the line with me here this morning. Let's talk about the Nova Scotia Health Authority and this NDP bill that was unveiled this week, a bill aimed at perhaps forcing the Nova Scotia Health Authority to hold its board meetings in public. I'm a little surprised that they're not in public, Gary.
Well, it's altogether surprising. It's surprising to discover that of all the provinces of Canada, only Nova Scotia holds its health authority meetings in secret. Only Nova Scotia is the jurisdiction where you can't get the minutes of the meeting. So at a time when we're facing a real crisis in our healthcare system, over 100 times without a family doctor, and the epidemic of emergency closures, at a hospital full of people waiting to be placed in nursing homes, but they're not hospital patients at all, they're nursing home residents for whom there are no places. When there is this great epidemic of crisis in the healthcare system, it's alarming to think that the people who are making these critical decisions are clothed in secrecy and are able to do all their work behind a curtain. We know that the best work that's done by government is done when there's a scrutiny of the public, when there's scrutiny of the media. This is why we have, with exceptions, very rare exceptions, we have our municipal governments, have open meetings, our school boards have open meetings, our legislature, our House of Commons have meetings. So to have such a critically important body in Nova Scotia able to function behind a cloak of secrecy, this is out of order and incompetent.
Well, listen, Gary, we're kind of, you're breaking up a little bit here, so I'm going to cut our conversation a little short, but I do appreciate your time this morning. Thank you very much, and have yourself a great weekend, sir.
Okay, you as well. Thank you.
All right, Gary Burrill, leader of the NDP here in Nova Scotia, and their Nova Scotia Health Authority Openness Act would make board meetings open to the public and force the NSHA to give public notification of when meetings will take place. Imagine, it sounds very similar to Halifax Water. Remember the discussion we had led by Councillor Matt Whitman trying to get access or trying to convince Halifax Water to hold its board meetings in public, something that Halifax Water has been refusing to do. And now we hear the Nova Scotia Health Authority also holds its meetings in camera and doesn't even give public notice of when those meetings will take place. So good for the NDP for doing that. Their proposed law would also make the agenda and minutes of those meetings publicly available. Just got to shake your head and wonder what's going on in this province that people are unable to, again, get access to attend these kind of board meetings, these very important board meetings. The Nova Scotia Health Authority, the only one of its kind in the country with a board of governors that meets in secret and whose work is completely shielded from public view. And the NDP wants to change that, and it's about time. And hopefully the McNeill government will see some wisdom in this NDP bill and will endorse it and again force the Nova Scotia Health Authority to meet in public and to tell us when they plan to meet and what is on the agenda of those meetings. Wow. Just, you know, I'm befuddled as to what's going on in this province with these boards and their total commitment to secrecy. It's absolutely disgusting. And hopefully, again, some good will come out of this NDP private members bill.